So we've been having our Christmas Eve dinner here at Huey's in Memphis. We are spending the night at the Peabody Hotel, not realizing that I had booked a bed and breakfast deal. And then we are also going to be doing brunch on the mezzanine tomorrow. So if I get my bed and breakfast deal, I'm going to have to get up early for that, because it's a buffet. And somebody riding on little scooters. But yeah, it's a buffet, and the brunch is also a buffet. So I'm gonna have to kind of figure that one out.
Yeah, it was.
This is Christmas Eve, so they have the night off, although it does smell like that they've been around not too long ago. Holiday Inn is sort of decked out for Christmas. I guess the smell just stays.
Oh, I think I saw a carriage earlier.
Okay. Which door do you want to go into?
Let's walk down this way just for a moment.
Okay. Going past Mike's Keys. Lucky Duck. The Peabody will both restaurants open on Christmas Day, along with their Christmas brunch. I don't think the restaurants are going to be serving their normal kind of meal. Wow! Nancy at the Peabody will be open on Christmas Day from 10 o'clock to 5:30. To kind of let you know just how popular the Peabody is at Christmas time. The dinner's at the Peabody tomorrow will be they're special ordered. You really don't have a choice of what you're ordering tomorrow. It is already priced, and I imagine that's so that they don't have to have a whole lot of staff on duty tomorrow. Of course, we're not anywhere close to Beale Street tonight. don't know if it's rocking any Christmas parties or not. Into the hotel, look at some of the Christmas decorations there. This door may be locked by this time. No, it's still open. Woo! The Peabody won't be as decked out as, say, the Opryland Hotel, but definitely enjoyed my Christmas Eve dinner at Huey's much better than I did my Christmas Eve dinner at Opryland Hotel last year. Side of the Christmas tree in the grand lobby of the Peabody Hotel. So we have Willy Wonka's Factory. Looks like to me somebody's messed up the gate to the factory. And then we get into the factory and we see the chocolate river. Oompa Loompas. That special boat. That special TV camera. Well, be careful and hope that it doesn't decide to suddenly take a picture of me here while I'm taking a picture of it. Could that be Charlie Bucket's house back there? There's a Wonka bar in front of it. Wonka bars all over the place. Hotel itself did, because the sign over there says something about it.
When I was pregnant, I got my eyes done, and like my eyes were better when I was pregnant. Now that I'm not, I can't see anything. I mean, I can see the road, but I can't read that little print.
Well, it just tells the gingerbread village was made with, and it tells everything that went into it. And then it just says the Peabody at the bottom of it. So that's why I'm thinking that the hotel. Well, I think by that's it. Oh, no. It would be the whole kitchen staff probably working on it. Just guessing.
Have you got a recorder on there, too?
Yeah.
Is that for personal? This girl, Jenna Marbles. think 30s. So I'm still sweating. You can see all of my face. Like, my hormones are going crazy. I suggest having kids around like 27, 28 if you want them. Because this is hard. I video.
Well, you have a Merry Christmas. I'm going to wander on around.
Oh, you bet. Yes, lots of stuff. You have a very Merry Christmas.
This is the first time that I've seen this, where they have a Instagram frame that you could probably take a picture with. Sure, that's what that's for. So now, while we are here at the Peabody celebrating Christmas, let's bear in mind that the saviors of the Peabody is the Bells family, and that they are Jewish. So right here, we have in the display case some of the things that go along with that. So let's wander around a little bit more. Nice Christmas tree up there on the mezzanine.
We get two, we can split it between us.